And very good evening to all of you. Chief guest of this evening, Mr. Deepak Sethi, IRS, DG Shipping, Ministry of Shipping, Government of India. And all the dignitaries present here, I am not able to take the name of all of you. And most of you actually have met just before this meeting in the beginning. We have a first advisory board meeting. And I can only say, proudly say that this time because of Mr. Sandeep Kalia, who could bring all the stakeholders responsible for oil spill creator plus response and mitigation. All those are available here in board today. I proudly say that we have got about 27 members, and I think few would be added after a few days. I think after getting the advice from this, today the advisory board suggesting that private sector companies who are also equally responsible for oil spill in Indian coast, Indian marine environment, they should be also part on board. So this will be, they will be also requested to be on board, so that all together we can work with one objective, how to avoid the oil spill and then respond and mitigate together if something happens, so the minimum damage happens in the ocean of India. So with this purpose we have met, and that meeting was very fruitful. Now at this, with the presence of Mr. Deepak Sethi, that will be launching this first inauguration of this launching of 2016 Oil Spill India Conference at Bombay. As Mr. Kalia has already spoken, that we have shifted from Goa to Bombay this time, seeing that there will be more response from the people, from the industry, more leverage will be able to draw, and ultimately the conference will be a meaningful conference, drawing attention from all stakeholders and beneficial to everybody. And ultimately, it should be benefit to the country. That is the purpose. That's why I'm telling, I'm not talking about the successful conference. I'm talking about the meaningful conference, which is more important for any type of conference. And that's why I suggested as a chairman of this conference for 2011 onwards, and that we must give a takeaway from each conference and then implement those takeaways, and for that success, ultimate success of the purpose of this holding this conference. And as rightly said, that environment pollution is a very serious matter. Any country for this growth, economic growth, needs energy. And today in world, about 90% energy is coming from the fossil fuel, that is coal, gas and oil, out of the majority of the fossil fuel, coal and gas, which is the most pollutant. At the same, because when they give the energy, when we burn, they ultimately produce carbon dioxide, which is ultimately causing the pollution to the environment. And if it happens to spill on the water in the land, it contaminates the sand, land. At the same time, in offshore environment, it spills. That means create a lot of marine environment problem, ecological imbalance. So many things happen. So that is a, there's a big problem for a marine environment containment. Because in onshore, we have got technology. At this onshore, it spills, does not spread too long with this containment area. There is a problem that control the people. Controlment is more problematic than actual mitigation of the oil spill. But in case of offshore environment, it is the ecological problem which is affected very badly. So we have seen some incidents, like I only in the, my initial remark also I spoken about this incident of the Gulf of Mexico, where on 28th of April this deepwater horizon accident has given a lot of what's called second the whole oil industry. If something happens to our wells, because India also now going for a deep water exploration and very aggressively, ONGC has already working, Reliance is working, so many private players are working today in deep water offshore in Indian water. And if something happened like deep water horizon in Gulf of Mexico, then what will happen to this marine environment in India? Whether we have got capability to mobilize so many resources, and also the policy, how to penalize those person who is polluting? That type of policy is also not in place today. So therefore, it is a big concern. So therefore, our main today in our case on oil exploration business in deep water, how to prevent it first? That means we should not compromise on safety of drilling operation in offshore environment, especially in deep water. We cannot take a chance. So therefore, deep water drilling today is very, very costly because of so many what's called safety measures have to be taken to avoid any untoward incidents, which may create a lot of problem. And when we analyze, we got the report of cause of accident in deepwater horizon. We found that a series of compromise on safety issue violated by the company in order to cutting costs. But in case of oil exploration, safety cannot be compromised because of requirement of cutting down costs. So it is impossible to think of it. I don't know such a big company, BP, how they have faulted those issues. When I gone myself, because I am a mechanical engineer, I am working drilling. When I gone through all those activities, they have violated, they bypassed. I could not believe such a big company can do so. And ultimately, one single disaster has been such a big disaster for them that economically that company, of course, BP could able to sustain that type of penalty. Nearly $24 is a compensation plus other expenditure they incur. I think nearly $40 billion investment or expenditure has to be borne by the BP. So apart from that, there are losses, but environmental damage, which is unaccountable. So those type of things cannot be thought of in Indian environment. So therefore, we are concerned about this oil spill prevention. If it happens, then response and mitigation, how it is possible to be done and with a good synergy among all the industries. So this conference, which we are going to have in 2016 at Bombay, will be addressing all those issues, commitment, synergy, and excellence. That is the theme of this conference we keep, and I think everybody liked it. And believe on that, we will work on that theme, and I believe this conference will be successful, and with the support of everybody, it should be a successful conference, and ultimately, it will have a good takeaway from this conference. And I request support from everybody. I believe I'm already getting it. So I'm very much confident that this conference will be very successful, meaningful. At the same time, support from the ministry, support from the shipping industry, support from the Coast Guard. I think we'll have a good, meaningful discussion, deliberation in this conference. With these few words, I welcome once again for the launching of this event by Mr. Deepak Sethi, DG Shipping. And with this, thank you.